You had it right. Test. E. You're hired.
That's about all I got left of me is one more album.
This album peaked at number one in Circus magazine.
Yes, it did.
This album did. Number one in Circus.
Yeah. I didn't know
did
that.
You guys read Circus?
Yeah.
I know this song. I watched the movie right before we went to Toronto. I think it was the night before.
Vanessa.
It was called So. It was a 50s movie called So Young, So Bad about a reform school for girls.
Aunt Frances?
And it had Aunt Frances. Or something. Yeah, she was really young, like 16.
Oh my God.
And can you imagine a reform school for girls? I was, I couldn't, I love that movie.
I tried starting one of those up.
I started working on this song. The minute the movie was over, I was writing this song. So. But it's also about this 14-year-old girl. That, well, I didn't know she was 14, but. No, I met a girl in Maryland after the gig. I think we played in Baltimore and went back to the hotel.
She was 21.
It was a great
Wait
time.
Wait a second, I was with her.
And then later, I was in Los Angeles, and these two girls were on the bus, and they were like, they rode the bus with us to Anaheim Stadium. And they were saying, oh, so you were with, I can't remember her name, Stephanie or whatever.
No, what's this?
And they go, you know she's 14. I was like, no. And they said, well, her dad's the governor of Maryland, and so they make sure her pills are always refilled. She's on the pill. Everything's cool. Her mom and dad know that, so this is kind of her right here.
Her and Anne Frances. All right, gentlemen.
And then I saw her later in L.A., and Joan Jett had her on a dog leash at a party. The same girl. I'm not kidding. She was walking her around on a dog leash.
slide guitar out there, Bobby.
Let's hear for Bobby and Orville. Sounds good, huh? Orville has not played the bass in 37 years. He hasn't kicked it up. Just for tonight.
Is he still an unemployed pussy
ass? Huh?
Is he still an unemployed pussy ass? Oh!
Being a pussy ass is a full-time job. He's fully employed. We'll be right back.
Listen to this acoustic guitar that Bobby's got inside of his electric guitar. Bobby, play him a couple of notes.
Oh,
world premiere, that's right.
Oh, world premiere! World premiere! Hold on, let me make sure I'm in tune, man.
That's the world premiere bell.
Heineken. All right.
I think we need the bell, dude. Somebody wants to get me a margarita.
Yeah, Bobby!
All right, fueled by alcohol. Gonna sound real good.
What?
Give me a pitch. Hold on.
A little more warning than that, Joey.
Wait till I get my brain freeze and then we'll...
That's your note.
Rocky, not in the high.
Hey, listen. All right. Another world premiere coming up. World premiere.
What's this now?
Thank you.
Can we get a hop up here? You all right?
Wouldn't be a gig without Orville spilling his beer. And Orville doesn't drink. He's not drinking that. Because Orville doesn't drink. How that beer's going to disappear, we don't know. He'll be gone, but he don't drink.
How about Magali Smith? Yeah! Richie Ranno!
How about these guys right here? How about these guys?
Jax, Dube!
Jim Jamaica!
Air clapping, please!
Captain!
Rod Evans on vocals. My hero, Rod Evans, Deep Purple original. Hush, hush, thought I heard a call of my name. Now hush, hush, move my heart, but I love it to say. Now hush, hush, little lady.
Hey, Brad, mute acoustic. Okay.
Hey, this is about Teresa,
you know. Oh, yeah, right. Teresa. She was untouchable to us.
Yes, she was. It
never happened before,
but untouchable. It was really like a weird thing. She didn't know what rock was. She was into disco. So we were like shit to her.
But she came over every day. In the cutest little clothes you ever saw. She was like, how old was she?
She was 18. But she looked 21.
She was fine. And then we were just like, I don't know, we couldn't
do it. She didn't give a shit. If we were like John Travolta's backup band,
but she came over every day.
Every day.
And her son, your brother.
In those clothes.
I think we were scared. It was Queens. We don't know how big her brothers were or cousins.
We used to rehearse there in this little, in this big studio, actually.
We rehearsed at Pink Floyd's studio in Queens, and Teresa would come in. And Mick was there. Mick the roadie, who you hear on Pink Floyd, where I really don't know, I was quite drunk at the time. You know that part on the end of,
I don't know what song it is.
I don't know, I was really quite drunk at the time. That's Mick from Blue Girl. Alright, so this is about Teresa, and she was untouchable, but we still remember her. She memorialized its song.
Just like you.
love girls. I love girls. I love me. I love all women.
Remember this one? This is not a world premiere.
No.
Although it feels like it.
It will.
Dude, give me a half a bell.
Of course you can play it.
What's this, Louie Louie?
It's not Corsica Nisa, sir.
You got it.
Excuse me?
You said you were Corsica.
Are you drinking mango juice?
Pomegranate.
Pomegranate. I'm telling Bonnie about your parents.
Yeah. You sit you bastard.
You sit you bastard. Yeah. I got nodges.
That's what happens when you marry a Sicilian marries a Northern Italian. A lot of resentment.
Completely.
Which is kind of like when somebody from New York marries somebody like me or Orville. Same thing. Rednecks from Alabama. Right.
The North and the South, you know, it doesn't matter what country it is.
That's divorce.
All right, we're going to attempt one now. Called. This was a letter that I wrote to Toronto to my wife. Yeah. Saying bye-bye. Yeah. I didn't mail it, though. That damn Yugoslavian girl, remember her? Anka Saborisic.
Vanessa.
Oh my god.
Vanessa.
Oh, she was Yugoslavian, Anka Saborisic. She showed up at.
I've got Alenka Delu.
And then, and her brothers had the. She had a father, Bluto, and a brother, Vlado, and another brother named something like.
Asshole.
Yeah, asshole. Oh, she was beautiful. Anka Saborisic. So. But she had immigration problems, so I couldn't take her over the border, so I didn't mail the letter to my wife. That's how it worked out. She had to stay in Canada.
Yeah,
an
age problem.
Yeah.
Than you guys, even if there was 20,000. Thank you all so much.
Lick it up! Lick it up!
That's how an Alabama boy has it.
We actually break the order of the album a little bit. Confusing.
You can't do that because people pay for this.
Yeah, don't confuse him, man. Look at him. Don't
just disregard what you're hearing. Go ahead, Bobby.
What are we doing?
Can we start on the scene?
A surprise for me?
I like surprises.
Songs, and it, believe it or not, with this low voice, it never was really Michael singing, it was always me. I got a falsetto that's higher than the ceiling.
Okay. You're sporting quite a package there, too, or won't notice that.
Surprise song.
Oh,
Wow. Everybody, it throws us off. It throws the three of us off to have two professionals playing with us. Sounds good, though. Sounds good.
Do we die?
Do we need oxygen?
Dude, didn't you used to have an oxygen tank?
Did we need that oxygen? Did you get the oxygen? Remember those days when we were at the end of the set?
He just put that.
Hyperventilated with oxygen.
How about when we had the smoke on the stage and I had to have the oxygen bottle down there and suck on it in that smoke and pull the plug?
That was my friend.
Probably ruined my lungs real good.
Get a cigarette.
Lying in dry ice smoke for 15 minutes. Damn, this drink is good. Or these drinks combined. I like it. Hold on. Oh, I don't have to sing now, do I? I can finish my drink, right? Go ahead.
You can just drink.
Take the stage. Thank you.
Wisconsin in the house. Michael from California representing Cali. Orville from the Florida State Penitentiary. Thank you guys. Hang tight. We gotta go rehearse it.